Now we'll study about meter bridge. About meter bridge, we can write that this is an experimental setup used to measure unknown resistance using the principle of a balanced Wheatstone bridge. I hope you can recall the situation of a balanced Wheatstone bridge, in which there are 5 resistances, and when the ratio of first 2 and last 2 resistances are equal, we say that the Wheatstone bridge is balanced. And under balanced situation of a Wheatstone bridge, no current flows through the middle resistance, which can even be removed without any effect on the circuit. Now let's have a look on this experimental setup of Wheatstone bridge, in which here you can see that AB is a wire which is 1 meter long. Because of this 1 meter wire only, this is called as meter bridge. And there are 2 gaps in the metallic strips for connection. In one gap, there is a known resistance RK which is connected. And actually, this RK is a resistance box through which any standard resistance can be taken out. And in the other gap, there is an unknown resistance which we connect, which is to be measured. And from the middle point of the metal strip, a galvanometer is connected, and the other end of galvanometer, which is connected to a jockey, is in contact with the meter bridge wire AB. Now, on the 2 terminals of A and B, you can see there is a battery connected along with a key. Now, if we close down the key, we can see a deflection in the galvanometer, and we can slide this jockey on the wire and locate a point where galvanometer will show null deflection. And here we can say, in the situation of null deflection, here the Wheatstone bridge is balanced, or we can say in the situation in null deflection state, here we can write the ratio of resistance RK and the length L of the wire must be equal to the resistance RUK divided by 100 minus L, because here we can see this situation is forming a Wheatstone bridge, in which the middle branch in which galvanometer is connected is showing null diffraction. That means the ratio of left 2 and right 2 resistances are equal. That's what we are doing here. We can say that if the jockey terminal is taken to be point J, then the resistance AJ and the resistance JB are in the ratio of length L and 100 minus L. If L is measured in centimeter, and on simplifying this expression, we'll get the resistance RUK, which can be written as now RK 100 minus L by L. And using this expression, we can find out the unknown resistance. And here this experiment can be repeated for different values of RK, and we can average out all the unknown resistance values we are getting for a better appropriate or better accurate value of the unknown resistance, which we can obtain by using this experimental setup.